Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you. This time I wanted to talk about the driver updates for your computer. So a lot of the hardware, you could have problems such as with the sound, network card, and that sort of thing. And a lot of people will have issues with that. And you need to update the drivers regularly, but because many people aren't updating their drivers, Microsoft started to push that out with their Windows updates. So that is a good intention, however, it creates a lot of problems for people. And when it doesn't work and you can't update it, you try to roll it back and it wants to force itself back in. There is a way to disable that and stop Microsoft from pushing the updates. So I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So looking at a driver update, there could be, you'll see the manufacturer of who provided the update. So a driver provider, in this case here is Intel for this audio driver. And if Microsoft updated it, it would say Microsoft here instead of Intel. And you'll see the date when it was updated and what the driver version is. So it's a good idea to have a look at this information, which is in the driver tab of the driver properties, and document that before you make any changes. With this, you can uninstall a device or try and roll it back if that option is available, or even update it. But if none of these options work, then you're going to need to disable the ability of Microsoft to update it first, and then you can go to the manufacturer's website to update it. So let's get into how to disable Microsoft's updating. So in the Start menu, if you click on Start and type in Gpedit, then you'll see the Edit Group Policy. Now, this is the easiest way to do it if you have Windows 10 Pro. If you don't have the Pro Edition, you're not going to be able to do this. So we'll make this a little bigger so you can actually see it. Local Group Policy Editor, what you want to do is go under the Computer Configuration and then Administrative Templates. You can either double click on it or hit the little arrow to the left of it. Then you want to go under Windows Components and then scroll down in the bottom pretty well. There is Windows Update. Now under the Windows Update, if you scroll down, you'll see an option here. Do not include drivers with Windows updates. So you can double click to open that. And it says not configured by default. So you can enable that. And that will stop them from updating your drivers for all the hardware in your computer through the Windows updates. So you would just hit apply and OK, and that's it, it's in there. And then you can just exit out of here. Now, just a disclaimer is that before going into the other method, that it is suggested to keep updates on, and it's always a good idea because no one ever really goes to the manufacturer's website to look for driver updates. So it's a good idea that Microsoft's at least taking care of this for you, unless you know what you're doing and you're going to be making a habit of doing your own updates. So this first method I just showed you was for the Pro Edition of Windows. If you don't have Pro and you're on the Home Edition, you need to go into the registry editor. So again, when you click on the start button, you can go to Regedit. And then in here, you want to go under the H key local machine, under software, scroll down to policies, expand that, open Microsoft, and then you want to go to Windows. You want to go into the next folder or key, which is called Windows Update. However, if you don't have the Windows Update folder, you'll have to create one. So to do that, you can right-click on the Windows key, go to New Key, and then just simply type in Windows Update exactly how you see it written here. With the Windows Update key, on the right side of the screen here, you can right click and go to new Dword 32-bit value. And the key for this is exclude WUDriversInQualityUpdate. And you gotta type this in exactly how it is here. If you don't, it may not work right. So I'll have the exact location and names for everything in the description below the video. So when you hit enter, it'll save that. Then you can double click to open that up. And you want to change the value from a 0 to a 1 and then hit OK. That enables that ability. So that's all there is to that. So as long as you have the home edition of Windows, you need to use the registry editor. Otherwise, if you have the pro edition, you can go through the first method I've shown you, which is a whole lot easier. So anyway, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you guys found it helpful. If so, please do give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and ring the bell to be notified every time we come out with a new video. All right, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.